Right, Citizen Chris here again. Just a quick one. You'll sign into your Robert Space Industries website. Go to my RSI. Under account, yes, that is a picture of me. It's not Mark Hamill at all, really. And under settings, you get the account overview and you get the referral program. So, since I don't know what my code is, I'll write it down there. And I referred so many people into this game and then they bought in the referral system. Not good. Anyway, if you see at the bottom the public test universe is in yellow, you can play. I have not ever received the invitation to play the PTU. I had that from day one that they let the PTU out. Anyway, click on that, and no matter what it says, you want to erase your account from the PTU first, and then you want your copy account to the PTU, and you will then get an email which allows you to log in using the the client, the what's the word I'm looking for, this thing. So I'm not going to show you the email, but the you just put your normal username in, and then you just tap it in there, and you should be in. I get it to remember, so I don't have to worry. I'm only doing this because I lost my 414 missile mounts, like size 4, one missile of size 4, on my Vanguard just a video or two ago. And I want to see if I get it back this way. All right, Citizen Chris signing off just for a moment. Hi, Citizen Chris here, back again. I've just redone my account. So the I should have those missile hardpoints available. But if you go to Voyager Direct under the store, and there's your UEC. And yeah, that's your only choice. I think it comes under weapons actually. Yeah, there's the missile point. So the 414s, I'm not buying them here, they are the 4000 UEC. I have 2000 UEC right now, but you permanently own them. So you can think of 1000 UEC being a dollar, I think. So I have spent $16 on these hard points. And then that's 625. Gotta be able, it's not good just buying these hard points, you have to have a ship that takes it. When the final version come on, well, the final version, when the live version of 3.0 will come out, you'll find that some weapons work better than others, and it's always different. That's what I've got. So what have I got, 100 quid's worth of these things? $100. I've got four of them puppies. So, you know, that's, I'm not quite sure how that's going to work in the game, but they certainly can't take it away from me. If they take it away, they'd have to refund me. The seven taking off the, That is, a lot of these I'm getting free with the ships I'm buying now, so it's quite cool. And kill that. Anyway, so I want to show you where all that was, and if we go into the actual game itself.
I think you're going to be happy with that.
Are you really? I'm back in this shop because do you remember I ran out of oxygen? So since I've just had to redo my account, buy some oxygen.
Do you need something? We just got
Could
a few
go.
Items in, so make sure to check them out.
Two or something, don't I? Something. Could be able to buy more than one, change the quantity or something. And I've already got one of these, but I'm buying a second one. I'll think about it. So if I go to my utilities, I can go down to the oxygen and add the oxygen in case I'm out, because it seems that we're using oxygen whilst we're flying. Refresh this. Helmet refreshes. Should take me back to that screen, really. Are you really? Let's try that one. No. Alright, whatever. Just do it again, I'll do it now. Belts and braces.
Is there anything I can help you with?
Yeah, don't you have an identical sister in the other shop? Anyway.
A lot of variety.
Yeah, I'm sure you do. I love some suction. I can't wait for it to get here properly. A bit like the Living Dead with some of these guys wandering around. What I could do with being a bit closer, right? Well, your eyesight's like, but mine's not that good. Hang on. And then halfway in between points. Oh, I keep trying to get out. You just back off now. Oopsie daisy, where are we? Here, aren't we? We've got this. Mind you, we came in through that dodgy door, didn't we? Not that this needs to be the same server. So doesn't he look like he's like, you know, waiting for his next hit or something, you know? That's better. See the warden. Torch on. Yeah. Right, so 414, so that's what I want to say. Put there, Italian on there, whatever it is. Ah, I got confused. Ordnance. There you go. Did I do the top one? I did the bottom one, didn't I? I just find it easier to not get lost if you use the same one. Back a bit. There it is. So, three. Good, let's do it. Come forward a bit. Hey. I was on the right hand side then, I was on the right hand side. Evidently. It makes sense that you can select the same one, because you could want to move it around and go, no, I want to put them on the back. One day we'll be able to select our missiles, and we can have a variety of missiles in here, and then we can you know, use them as needed. So rather than trying to blow an aurora out the sky with a size 4, which is a bit of a waste, at least it was. There we go. Oh, of course we've got a gun on the front, haven't we? Can't do anything about with these at the moment. It's size 2s. So there are some advantages to putting a different gun on here. But I'm going to put the cheat gun, or the turret gun, I think. Can't remember which one. So it's the M7A size 5 laser. Inside it goes puh, puh. Outside it makes a big noise, apparently. So, there's another problem with the buying a PTU, is it won't let me assist those things I've owned. I recommend, by the way, and we'll have a look at it in a second. I believe I've still got it open. I recommend rec. So instead of buying these things here and getting it from Voyager Direct, go to Electronic Access. You will earn rec points by playing the multiplayer version of Arena Commander, or being a subscriber, and I have like 1.2 million rec points because I don't spend them. And you can try ships out. Yeah. I would say that's, to get the Delta, it's probably 2 or 3 runs through Arena Commander, depending on how good you are. And if you're not very good, you practice, you keep going in, and you'll get wrecked. You have to finish, you're not good at quitting out. Weapons, for instance, 6,000 UEC is something you can't earn in game at the moment. And here it's only 400 rec higher, so you can try these things out, see what missile loadouts you like. It doesn't take you long, so you can go out in a standard Aurora and immediately start putting some decent weapons on her. Yeah, after playing a few rounds of Arena Commander where you're just learning how to fly the ship. Yeah, got a few of these as well, which I put in my Taliator. That's the big one I've got on the front, on the chin of my Vanguard. That door shut. Toilet door. Toilet. All good. Turn my torch off. There's like emergency lighting on. There's F5.
Aegis combat assist.
Hold down F, have a look.
Systems green.
Not a lot going on at the minute. But anyway, we shall see. Have a look at the external view. Good. Now, I didn't delete my users folder, so my joystick should still be mapped. She goes. Caterpillar there. Just in and out. You can press F1 from here. Well, you can if you press F1. And we see what missions are available. No idea what this ship is like at the moment. Missing crew, black box, collection, disposal, garbage. I'm not doing that. Escort. Immediate start. Don't worry about the money. We start off with a million in this version because we're not worried about the money. Alright, let's go for it. If we accept it, highlight it, and now should be tracked. And it should be on the map. Rendezvous, that's over there. So I think I can just point and shoot actually. Let's come out of that. There we go. We're putting the mouse down. No, not letting me point and shoot. You were getting the ability to jump by punching your nose at a target earlier on, but obviously not now. So, is that, was it? One with the mission diamond on it. It's highlighted behind. See, that's gone to double diamond configuration. So hold down B.
Autumn travel initiated.
Not growing old on me this at the moment, I've got to say. Extremely pretty. Pretty. Now what? This way. Now we can point and shoot the OM, so I'll show them this stands the O stands for orbital or something. And there's a rendezvous, it's not that far away. So, put the foot down. Climb out of the asteroid belt. And yellow. Now in real life, and I mean real life, if you're in an asteroid belt, you'd be lucky to ever see two asteroids in the same visual scope. Of course, this isn't real. The mouse is close to its left side, right side. Ooh. Do M. Okay. There we go. Those just joining the game, these are procedurally generated asteroids, and most of them. Previously they were each individually handcrafted, and that's why there are more now than there were before. That's interesting. I've got the good. That is not good. I do things with this. Good. Come out of that. 90 kilometers from the rendezvous, you do shift at this speed. Almost at a point where we can have an inertial dampening field as they have in Star Trek, so obviously not in the Star Citizen universe. I can see it not being in a light fighter, but this is medium heavy. Right, it's close, so. It'll pick him up. My point is about all the different colours is your blood drains in and out of your head and your eyeballs. Do we have comms yet? Is that what we're doing? Comms? Fleet rendezvous with ship? No comms. Well, don't see what we're doing. I hope he's coming up to me. That means we're going to be coming out of the asteroids as opposed to being in them. I used to play the Drake Herald a bit, and you can't exactly fight with that one. What you tend to do is you tend to try this again. Oh, I've got this mouse pointer right in the middle of the screen here. I have an asteroid right in my face. A bit of boost. I've got a 21 alpha UEC for something. Getting a combat pay bonus. What we got? Oh, it's a Connie. My first ever ship. Look at missile boats. You don't need a freelancer miss if you've got the Connie, I tell you that. Hold position. I'm supposed to match, am I?
Contact.
Alright, here we go. Straight forward. Where is he? There's my target. I can't seem to see any selected bad guy, so I'm gonna press F. I would press F. F is doing something to my power. Oh, what is going on? Oh, I've got two missiles on me. Brilliant. Locked. Why can't I lock on the bad guy? Where is the bad guy? Is it him? Not that, is it? Something else. Yeah. Hardly done much of an escort job at this range. I'm going down to zero and I'm boosting. That's taking me down to zero, isn't it? Well, I'm sure I saw an enemy, but I think he must have hit an asteroid or something. The persistence of the missile lock is not uncommon. Sure you're still used to that in T-16, aren't you? I think she does about 185. God, I hate using the keyboard for this. I'll definitely use the So you could choose to pick up the throttle, Chris, but I'm worried about injection. Oh, they're going to eject from the guard like that. Zero at the time, it's so annoying. No. That is the first mission I managed to get doing apart from the debacle at Kobolex. So if I take it down to... anything, she just drops down to zero. Just put the HOTAS joystick, HOTAS throttle into full. I'm going to try and pull it back without trying to hit any boosts. I think 185 is speed on it. Try pressing M. Got me what it is in the HOTAS to do the max speed. That should get slightly ahead away from me. I can't even lock onto the friendly. Looks more like 190 to me then. Slowing down. Well, this would be more interesting had I been able to shoot something. Mighty 10 frames a second, which is crazy. I did a video to show you how to play 263 in local on your hard disk. You can't buy or sell anything or get any rewards, but you can play at the full speed of your computer. Walking along, depends what screen you're on. I've got 144 monitor on my other display, and I can rock along at that kind of frame rate. Pretty reasonable system. 32 gigs of RAM helps. I've got a 6 core i7, I think it's 4990 something K. That's the extreme overclockers edition. Not overclocked, of course. I'm assuming this mission is still going on, I'm just following this dude. What was that? That's still going. Combat pay bonus against hostile forces. Hold until scan is completed. That research against battle force. Have done that one. Meet with the researcher's ship and rendezvous beacon. Alright. Typical mercenary, I didn't bother reading the instructions. Hey, what the heck? Oh, some steam. I think it's that guidance just wiggling them and I'm wiggling to compensate. I don't know. Taking a while, isn't it? Merlin in the back there. Tail of the ship. Because I'm passing through their wake. Not going to press boost. Come on, give me something to shoot at. Wow. I've got one of those Amazon Echo things. She's sitting there listening to me, so I don't really want to go. Alexa, what's the time?
It's 12:50 p.m.
Oh, you got to hear that. But the I asked her to tell me a joke, and the first joke she said, "What do you get if you cross a joke with a rhetorical question?" And that's the best joke she's ever told me. Alexa, tell me a joke.
Waiter, waiter, this food's not fit for a pig. Terribly sorry, I'll fetch you some scraps and PMs.
I didn't hear a word of that. Where's she gone? She stopped. We've stopped. We live in hope of this mission ending. Alexa, repeat that joke.
Waiter, waiter, this food's not fit for a pig. Terribly sorry, I'll fetch you some scraps and peelings.
You know what? I don't think it's worth listening to. I also think we're frozen. Let's go to crash report if it's going. There we go. That's why she stopped. I think that mission just went on ridiculously too long and it just failed. So, what can we learn from this? Well, first of all, at the moment, if you bought anything on UEC and you lose your ship, then you have to basically, you know, wipe and restart your account. Which I don't like the sound of. This area, visit space above Crusaders, area 18. Not offering me area 18, is it? Oh well. And, the missions are bugged, but, you know. I don't know why, I don't know why content producers are whining and moaning saying it should do this, it should do that. It shouldn't do anything. They're just privileged to be able to play the PTU, believe me. And for all of you guys out there who aren't playing the PTU because you can't get in, you know what I mean. Yeah? You don't understand what a PTU is, you shouldn't be in it. But stop moaning, you guys. There goes. Okay. You know, apart from that little nonsense, I'm starting to like this. I haven't got one. I'm starting to kit and colours. Oh, I'm on the back. You can't shoot at the moment, you have to hold on to that back handlebar. You see that? I do that. Okay. And F gets off it. Head around. And I will do a hangar one once I'm sure the hangars are going to be good. There's the pilot. So you got this stupid blue thing in the way at the moment. It's a five.
Hello and welcome aboard your Drake Interplanetary Craft. Your systems are online.
Are they really? But I can't do anything in it. Give an exit left, exit right. Something there. Ah, that one. Oh. Look on this cross, get rid of it. gun. And oh yeah, Egypt dress. Have a look in the hotline. Have a look at the Vanguard. The Vanguard would not have my missiles on, because there's no relationship with the Vanguard and the hangar and the Vanguard and the PTU. There's the hoplite. It's the one I don't own. I can hear she's on fire already. That little drop. Come on. Oh, this is going to be worth seeing when I get in. There we go. There's a wider rear door. This is really a supposedly troop transport. Yes, you could get a grey cat buggy even. I spawn a grey cat buggy. Give me that table, isn't it? Oh, sorry. But it's just that table, isn't it? The hologram table. Hologram. Not a snooker table or a billiard table. And the idea is somewhere. Yeah. You pick up ICC probe. What has happened to the ICC probe? It looks better in the not so bright hangar of the industrial. Oh well. Let's go and have a look. So it's a drop ship, so the idea is this bottom, I believe, is supposed to be able to open up and you drop. I think I'm miles up in the air here. There's my teeth, my tongue, and my nostril hairs. Nice. And I am quite a large way off the ground. So I'm on the ground. Good. You can see things from the ground point of view, yeah? So there's these seats, and the idea is I think you're supposed to just run out the back. They're not enjoying being down there. We're on a road to nowhere. Come on. Get out of here. Yeah, it's a mess. So I did a video on bouncing Connies, so hopefully you've seen that one. If not, why not? He's bound, but he's only got a cockpit. Best thing about this puppy is when it changes shape. I should take this into space because it's the hyperspace jump, or the quantum jump, or what the heck you want to call this thing. Was always different in the cartoon, and I don't know whether they bothered doing it here yet, but you know, the Apollo Nox is made by the same sort of technology, so The steps down here are floating on a magnetic field. The story. And that's why these sort of panniers on the power knox are sort of floating near you, not actually connected to the pipe. Which is really cool. The freelance is fairly good in the game at the moment. Get out of the way. Ooh, that was a nasty bounce. Nice guns. It should be a lot smaller than this. The water is particularly good in Manchester, so everything grows bigger. What the heck is this thing? Oh, that's nice. Floating component. Excuse me. Why can't you just lean forward and press F5?
Hello, how can MISC help you today?
Well, you can let me out of the seat. Why don't I do that? Why don't I get out? There we go. Now she's powered on. Beds, darky things keep you up for the night. Absolutely the wrong place components. And the back door shut again. Stop. Nice ship. Got a few of your mates just running around in that. Lots of different missile hardpoints. Based on the Firefly series spaceship, which is based loosely on something called the Hooded Swan, would you say? Which is a very famous science fiction ship. But even the people of Firefly don't know that's where the original mech area came from. The other thing about the Hooded Swan is it was VR. It was long before we had VR. You were newly linked to it. Not being able to change the pace of running the wheel mouse. Anyway, I'm going to sign off in a second. And try and get all these videos together for you in some kind of 1, 2, 3, 4 format. Oh, that's annoyingly slow now. You will be. Have you got a headache? You soon will have with this lift. From the makers of all headache pills worldwide comes this lift. Laughing at me now. Anyway. Favorite hangar in the game. Desk things you can put on here. As I said, we'll have a proper good look at this once we got the There's the Redeemer. Or the Reclaimer, should I say. Always thought it'd be bigger, didn't you? These things have a kind of on-off position. Maybe I'm... Supposed herald. Anyway, this is Itz and Chris signing off. I'm going to try and get something for lunch. And I hope you're having a good one. I'll be sorting these videos out as I'm eating. Cheers then.